What is the best social media management tool? You guys know I've tested them all and I haven't made up my mind until now because Hootsuite has added new features that are a game changer for social media managers. I've partnered with them to showcase you these new features, so let me show you right away why I think you'll love these new Hootsuite features as well. We are now here in Hootsuite and I'm going to share with you my favorite features. We have everything a social media manager needs. We can schedule and create content in here. We also have a new AI feature, your OwlyGPT. You can manage your inboxes in here, so you can do all of your inboxes. I manage my DMs from Instagram and TikTok in here. We have a very powerful analytics part, which I'm going to share with you. It's going to be a game changer for your analytics. We can run ads through Hootsuite, and we also have a powerful social listening tool. But let's start with one thing that will save you time already, and that is the DM automation. When we go on create and click DM automation, you can now do all your DM automations directly in Hootsuite, which is super helpful because now you don't need multiple tools, right? So we can tell the automation what kind of keyword we want it to trigger. So if someone comments a specific word, they will get a comment reply in a direct message. You know how it works. Comment free guide, and then via DM, they will get sent the free guide. You can do all of that inside Hootsuite. But let's say you have no idea what to post and you want some help. So you're gonna go on to OwlyGPT and we can ask it anything you want. I'm gonna say, what should I post as a social media manager? And there we go, we have some answers here, and now we can even go further and ask more questions and continue this. You know how it works. And I can say which channels I wanted to post to. So this is gonna be a static post, so I'm not gonna do TikTok. And then down here, I can obviously customize my auto-generated caption, and I can also say add more AI suggested hashtags, which is very powerful, so you don't have to research it yourself. So I'm just gonna add some hashtags, and then I'm gonna add my image here. You can either upload it from your computer or directly from a media library if you already have one. And then on the right-hand side, we will see a preview on how our post will look like on the different platforms. We can just go on schedule for later, and then it tells you what the recommended times are for your post. So I'm gonna do this, click done, and then everything has been scheduled. I can now go into my plan and see how it looks like. There we go, all the posts for tomorrow are scheduled. If you work with bigger brands or companies, it is super helpful to know what's going on the internet about your brand. So what kind of conversations or what kind of comments are being held? And we can monitor all of that in a social listening tool. So we can go on here and we can type in a brand name, a location, a person, whatever we want, and then we'll get an overview of what's been going on about that specific keyword. We can also compare it to something else and really get a good idea what's been going on online about the brand that we're working with. Now let's move on to my absolute favorite part, and that is the analytics feature. I feel like a lot of you guys are still doing analytics either manually or don't pay attention to it. Having your analytics and your data is one of the most important part as a social media manager, because really here we learn what our audience likes and what they don't like so that we can create more content that they will actually engage with. So I'm gonna show you how you can use your data to really create better content. So Hootsuite gives me a social score and some insights about my account. So you can read through that your own account. It will analyze your most engaging post, what you did well, and it will also give you recommendations. So this is all AI-based. And then obviously you have an overview of what's been going on your account. This is helpful for you, but really what I like to do is dive deeper into each specific part. So let's go into the post performance. We are now on the post performance specifically for Instagram. We're using this as an example, and we see our top performing posts. I can also change the date rate if I want to see last month or compare it to something else. I can do that here as well. So now we see this here has been my most performing post, and right away I also see the engagement rate. This is again very helpful because only with this kind of overview you see a trend. What is your audience liking? So here we can see every time I talk about clients or a talk about pricing, we had the highest engagement rate. So that tells me in the future to do more of that content, right? And then if I scroll down, I can look at what hasn't performed so well so that I know maybe that's something I won't be doing in the future. But now let's assume it's the end of the month and we want to create a report for our client. We're going to go on the top on create report and then create a custom report. I can now add the metrics that I like and that I feel are important for my clients. I can also use one of the reports that are already pre-made for me. But again, I like to have a custom report. So I'm going to do one for Instagram engagement and I'm just going to add some different metrics that I need. And there you go. We have our Instagram engagement custom report. I have my top posts here and then we have more metrics down below. So if I want to change anything on here, I can do that. So let's say I don't like these lines here. I prefer it to look like that. Quickly change that with a few clicks. So now I can show my client the shares and the comments that we have, but more powerful as well down here is which posts led to more followers and what's the age range for our most engaged audience. Again, very important so that in the future we can create content that talks to this specific audience. So we can customize everything in this report. Once I've gone through and look at what I have on here, I might want to add another metric. So I'm just going to click add metric and scroll through what else I want to add. I'm going to add post shares as well. And you can see down here we have now post shares. I can also move everything around. If I want this to be more on the top, we can move this all around. And then we can also customize this whole section. So again, we already talked about different visualization parts. I can share it the way I like it best. And I can also change the title. There you go. We quickly changed this report and added more metrics. We can also add a note. You can make this fun or you can do the most important learning on the top here. For example, we increased engagement rate 10% compared to last month in an ideal world. Or you can just have a fun little note. Then we're going to export this whole report. And we can do that as a PDF or any other format you like. You're going to click PDF. And this is how our report will look like. We have our logo. We can also add our client's logo. And then we have all of the data that we need to share with the client, either send this via email or do a call with the client. Maybe you're a new social media manager or you don't actually know what's a good number. So what is a good engagement rate for your industry or your client's industry? And has your account actually performed well or not? That is something you can also do inside Hootsuite. So it takes out the guesswork. We're going to go on to analytics on the left hand part. We're going to click onto industry and here you can set your industry or your client's industry. So you can just click select industry. And then here we have all the different industry that you can choose from and how big the business size is. So I'm choosing entertainment and media for mine. And you will see the average engagement rate and the average numbers for that specific industry compared to my account. So my engagement rate is higher than the average engagement rate. You also see the post frequency and we can see some more data down here, how I've reached my audience and so many more numbers that might be helpful for you if you want to dive deeper about specific numbers or an average KPI in your industry. We can also do a competitor analysis. So when you click on competitive analysis, you can select a competitor, add a competitor, and then compare your numbers with a specific competitor. Again, gives you great insight on where you're roughly at. You can test Hootsuite for free yourself. I post the link below for you to try it, and then let me know how you like Hootsuite.